Hello and welcome to Making It Big Season 8. I'm your host AB Ravi. To reiterate my message of last week, we are hosting this series Making It Big for the 8th year in succession. It is one of the longest running shows on CNBC TV 18. So over the next few weeks, we will be showcasing success stories of Indian entrepreneurs which are inspirational and aspirational. I'm sure it will serve as a guiding light for budding entrepreneurs as well as for those already doing business. With that, let me turn my focus to this week's episode. Well, the focus is on the moving force behind this company. And the person is Dr. Lalit Kanodia, widely hailed as one of the pioneers of the Indian software and offshore services industry. And interestingly, Dr. Kanodia was part of the initial team which set up TCS in 1967. But like most Marwaris, Dr. Kanodia wanted to be his own boss. Thus, in 1975, he set up Datamatics. In the last 42 years, this Mumbai-based company has grown from 10 people organization to 9,000 employee company with footprints across the globe. What made this possible is the company's ability to leverage data to extract intelligence and pattern, which in turn facilitates smarter and quicker decision making for its clients. Take a look at the Datamatics story and you will realize that size does not matter in business. What matters is excellence.
Indefatigable is the word to describe the 76-year-old Dr. Lalit Kanodia. At this age, most men hang up their boots and spend time with their grandchildren. Not him. As the chairman of Datamatics Global Services, Dr. Kanodia still runs the business with childlike passion, clocks long hours, and continues to trot the globe. These qualities have yielded rich dividends. In the last 42 years, Datamatics has grown from a 10-people firm to a 9,000-employee listed company. Likewise, its turnover has grown from 10 lakh rupees in 1975 to 835 crore rupees in 2017. This Mumbai-based company is a global provider of consulting, information technology, data management and business process management services to several Fortune 500 companies operating in banking, insurance, transport and the publishing space. As is evident from the client list, the biggest market for Datamatics is the US, which contributes 65% to its turnover, followed by Europe with 20%, India at 12%, and other markets at 3%. But what differentiates the company from its peer group is that Dr. Kanodia is clear that he is not in the rat race or to be part of any global rankings. He wanted to do a few things, but do them extremely well. That is why he consciously built the core operation of the company around data to intelligence, wherein Datamatics leverages data to extract intelligence and patterns, which in turn facilitates smarter and quicker decision-making for its clients. Its differentiated offering strategy by keeping customers at the center of its universe has ensured a long list of loyal customers.
Well, I think there's a few things that appeal to us as it relates to the relationship with Datamatics. One is the partnership. They are a company that does not treat customers like clients. They treat us like partners, just like we treat our customers. And one of the things that I found very attractive with the relationship is they learn about their customers, their partners. We've worked very closely with them to help them understand what makes us tick as an organization, and they've been very open with helping us see how they operate as well. They've been flexible, they've been very willing to adapt to our ways of doing business, as well as helping us understand why alternate modes of operation might be more beneficial in trying to drive our business forward.
Well, Well, such encomiums from global customers is the outcome of Dr. Lalit Kanodia's avowed philosophy of trying to be ahead of the curve by constantly reinventing himself. Lalit was born in 1941 into a business family in Kolkata. He was the eldest in the family, consisting of five brothers and one sister. In 1942, the family shifted to Mumbai. Lalit's father, Surajmal Kanodia, was the largest bullion trader in the country, but died in an air crash in 1951, and the mantle fell on his mother. To her credit, all the six children graduated from IIT Mumbai. After his IIT, Lalit went abroad for higher studies. After his master's degree in MIT, he came back to India for a brief period and met with J.R.D. Tata, who asked him to study the feasibility of computerization of the Tata Group. After completing this assignment, Lalit went back to the US to do his PhD. After his studies, he came back to India. In 1967, he set up Tata Computer Center, which is known today as TCS. After successfully guiding and directing the company for about 8 years, Lalit was smitten by the entrepreneurial bug. So he set up Datamatics in 1975. With a staff strength of 10, the firm, operating out of the SBI building in Fort, initially offered services for data processing and payroll. The first turning point came in 1979, when it set up a dedicated offshore development center for Wang Laboratories. After that, there was no looking back. In 1991, Datamatics set up the country's first satellite link for software development between Mumbai and USA for AT&T Bell Labs. And thus was laid the foundation of BPO services in India. In 1994, Dr. Kanodia's eldest son, Rahul, after graduating from Columbia University, came back to India. Initially, he worked in various departments to understand the nuts and bolts of the business. And then, in very much keeping with the changing times, Rahul rejigged the company and repositioned it from a service-led organization to a solutions and product-led organization. Today, Datamatics has a fully integrated offering to support digital transformation of organizations through smart processes, smart systems, smart devices, and smart data. These solutions are powered by robotics, artificial intelligence, and machine learning algorithms, which offer improved business efficiency in the interconnected world. This constant quest to excel and anticipate clients' needs seems to be the DNA of Datamatics.
There are two fundamental sort of things that I see which differentiates Datamatics from others. One is, across the entire organization, there is this ingrained DNA amongst each of us around how can we make things smarter. How do we enhance an enterprise-level productivity? How can I bring a process time down? How can I increase the efficiency of the process? How can I increase the quality? How can I reduce the number of people who sort of work on it, and so on and so forth? Which is very different from how some of the others operate, who focus more on FTE-related businesses. Right? Here we focus on automation, and how can we think out of the box?
Well, going by the mood at Datamatics headquarters in Mumbai, it seems like the Kanodias are getting ready for the next growth cycle. Witness this. Between 1997 and 2003, the company made only 2 acquisitions. But in the last 5 years, it has made over a dozen acquisitions, and all of them successful. All these are reflected in its financials. Between 2012 and 2017, the company's turnover grew from 441.89 crore rupees to 867.12 crore rupees, recording a CAGR of 14%. The net profit during the same period grew from 28.25 crore rupees to 88.91 crore rupees, clocking a CAGR of 26%. So the moot point is, will it be a new Datamatics 5 years from now? To get answers to those kind of questions, CNBC TV18's AB Ravi talks to Chairman Dr. Lalit Kanodia and Vice Chairman Rahul Kanodia of Datamatics Global Services. Also joining us on the show will be Rajat Varma of HSBC. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. Between 1997 and 2003, the company made only two acquisitions, but in the last 5 years, it has made over a dozen acquisitions. Looks like the Kanodias have chalked out ambitious growth plans. I caught up with Dr. Lalit Kanodia and Rahul Kanodia at the corporate office located at Andheri in Mumbai to understand the business philosophy and find out whether Datamatics is their only mission. This is what they have to say. Take a look. Dr. Kanodia, Rahul, Rajat, welcome to the show. What made you set up Datamatics? You were very well ensconced in the Tata Group. So was it family pressure that Marwadis don't work for others?
Fault is genetic. Okay. It's a part of my DNA. You know, coming from a business family, I could not see myself as an employer too long.
What made you confident that now I'm not going to go back to working to TCS anybody? What was the one big order you got that was the turning point for your business?
The main turning point which really transformed the company was our agreement with Wang Labs. Wang was the fastest growing computer company in the US at that time. And Wang introduced word processing, by the way. So we tied up with Wang and we started selling their computers in India as their distributor. And then they gave me a break to develop software for Wang itself. And the first assignment we got to develop an Arabic word processing system. You won't believe it. Now we knew, didn't know Arabic and we didn't know word processing. But as the luck would have it, we delivered and they were absolutely astounded and they sold a lot of their machines to the Gulf countries and that started the whole thing. So they started pushing us worldwide to all the distributors that use Datamatics to develop software.
Okay, let me get Rahul in. Rahul, Dr. Kanodia built the company to a certain critical mass. Mm-hmm. So you entered the scene sometimes in 1994. So when you came and joined the company, what was the scene and what did you do after that?
When I came back, I got involved in one of the companies that today does not exist. We divested that company, which was into distribution of security solutions, networking solutions, and all of those things in India. And then for 6 years, I was involved with that business and I sort of moved around a little bit in Datamatics. I got involved with HR and with finance and a little bit of sales and a little bit of software development. And so I sort of moved around a little bit. And consequently, it gave me a good overview of the entire organization and all the different functions that we have. And I really sort of got into the saddle in 2000. 2000 was just after the Y2K boom. You know, the Y2K boom had happened. Yeah. India was hot property as far as you know, software was concerned. The dot-com boom was pretty much there at that time. And that's when sort of I shifted gears and took change. Till then, we were largely a services company. And since then, we've transformed into more of a solutions company, a products company. We have several products today.
Branded products?
Branded products that we sell into the market. And solutions, which is slightly different from services. So in a solution, you understand the customer's business problem, and then you build a solution that addresses that business problem, including implementing some products, including building some software, and then sort of package it and give it to the customer.
So in terms of transformation, what you did, did it give a huge traction to the business domestically or all exports driven?
So it was largely exports. Datamatics has traditionally been focused on exports. Our domestic business, you know, initially, of course, we started with India. And then at some point, we de-grew in India and grew internationally. And our focus until very recently was largely the international market. It's only in the last 5 years that once again we started focusing on India. In terms of these services, software solutions. Having said that, our R&T business was always plugged into the Indian markets.
Okay, let me get Dr. Kanodia again. What is the challenge of your business? Is it competition, is it talent acquisition, or is it technology disruption, or it is the protectionist world today?
So the greatest challenge now for all Indian companies, including Datamatics, is how do we change our direction from pure vanilla services to selling intellectual property. And that is the current challenge that we have.
Okay, now let me get Rajat in. Rajat, you heard the promoters so far. So what's your take listening to the story?
What differentiates Datamatics
and where does it go from here?
Yeah.
In fact, the first time when I met Rahul, he was most passionate. So he was telling me about his whole business and about the IT services piece, which is something that I'd heard before from other IT companies, and clearly Datamatics does a lot of that as well. But he, I think his level of energy went up when he started talking about data analytics, robotics, and also the tagline which came repeatedly, which is that, I think it was data to intelligence. And that's what I think appeals to me the most, because we face it in banking, we see our other customers face it. We have such a lot of data that you do want to make sure that you're making good use of it. And actually, we know that we need to make better use of it. So that's what appeals to me about the philosophy most.
What comes out about your company is, at one level, is a very conservative company. You're not swayed by peer group pressure. Mm-hmm. You stick to knitting as the management term. Were you not swayed by that you want to diversify into new areas? You only stuck to the IT sector.
I think it's got to do with our training. All of us in the senior management have studied abroad, lived abroad, come back. And one key thing that comes out is stick to your core competence. And our core competence is understanding technology. That's one. The second is that the field in technology is so vast and is still very, very vibrant. Today you hear a lot about a potential slowdown and things like that. Some of it is true, but I still think there's a huge opportunity with all this digital transformation that you have with analytics, robotics, artificial intelligence, and all of these things, mobility, IoT, all of these things coming together. I think the opportunity is extremely rife to capture and to grow. And when an opportunity is so rife, even today and even when it was in the past, the question is, why should you diversify? You can make money in your core competence, you're good at it, and why should you run to 10 different directions? Because that only dilutes your core competence. So we therefore consciously stuck to our core knitting, and I think it's all going very well for us.
Do you believe in luck, looking at your own career growth and the way life has panned out?
See, what brings success is a complex question. Part of it is luck, but it's not only luck. I think it's less luck combined with a variety of factors. It's a very complex equation in my opinion. I know very gifted people who fail, and people who are not at all gifted do brilliantly in life.
What are the mantras you applied in your business that made it possible for you to reach to this level?
One, according to me, if you really want to succeed, you got to work hard. You got to put in 110%.
Okay, sure.
In our case, in my whole family, we are very honest to our purpose. So we take pride in the fact that we don't go astray.
Okay.
We walk the...
Very focused.
We walk the straight road.
Yeah.
Three, be good to everybody else. We've never wished bad of anybody else. So we've... And go overboard to meet your client's expectations.
Okay.
So if you do these three things and be honest with yourself, very good chances succeed, unless God wills otherwise. And I think God blesses those who try hard. So I personally think it...
So if a youngster came to you for advice, what would your advice be, the do's and don'ts of business, if he or she wants to start today?
Don't try and do too many things. Become a niche player and stay the course for a fairly long period of time. You try and do too many things at the same time, chances are you will not succeed unless you have very deep pockets.
Okay.
And very few of us have very deep pockets. So choose what you do very carefully. Once you've chosen, stick with it for a fair amount of time, and chances are you'll succeed.
Actually, for an entrepreneur, I would add, I think many people have this entrepreneurial bug today. Startups are hot. Everybody is looking at startups. I think a key element would be to focus on cash flows. Yeah, absolutely. And very often they don't, and they take pride in saying, okay, I'll get a good logo, I'll get a good customer, I'll do it free, it gives me the brand. I don't mind bleeding for 5 years so that we get the market share. But I think that's antithesis to business. In business, focusing on cash flow, typical Banyabuddhi Marwadi is most important.
Yeah. But Dr. Kanodia says, don't be jack of all.
Yes.
Just unless you have very deep pockets.
Only very deep pockets. Very well put, Dr. Kanodia. Thanks for being on the show. Rahul, thanks for being on the show. Raja, thanks for being on the show. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ravi.
Well, that was the father-son duo sharing with conviction their vision and mission. These are the mantras they implemented to build Datamatics. Work hard and always give your 100%. Always meet your client's expectations. Be intensely focused on your goals. Don't try to do too many things. Luck is not the key to success. It combines with a variety of factors to make you successful. Well, these are simple but effective mantras, I would say. Dr. Kanodia wanted to do few things and do that well. He was not swayed away by the peer group pressure. Before I go, here is an interesting observation made by Jeff Bezos of Amazon, and it fits Datamatics well. And I quote him, "If you are competitor focused, you have to wait until there is a competitor doing something. Being customer focused allows you to be more pioneering," unquote. On that thinking note, it is time to say goodbye. See you next week with another interesting episode. Till then, keep watching CNBC TV18.